Okay, we were discussing Smith normal form for a matrix with polynomial entries. So let us review some of the things attached to a matrix with polynomial entries that we have seen last week. So first of all, we always, okay. Last week, we took an n by n matrix. The things that I defined is actually true for more general, not necessarily square matrices, but I will keep on taking square matrices. So we take an n by n. So this is our notation. F, F is a field, Fx, this polynomial ring, if you take a field as coefficient, then it becomes a principal ideal. So we take an n by n such matrix. Along the way, we define this notation. So delta k, so let me say delta k of A. So we say that this is the greatest common divisor of k root minus of A. So you can also take it like this. This is equal to the greatest common divisor of all k by k minus of A, k by k minus of A. Okay. And so let me also introduce another notation here. We know what rank of a matrix means. So here, maybe if you look at some books, you may see such a notion. So this is rho of A. So this is the determinantal rank, the determinantal rank of A. So this is, so let us define this. The largest integer R, the largest integer R, R for which there exists, a non-zero R by R minus of A. And so here, remember, to find this greatest common divisor, you look at all K by K minors of A, and then you take the greatest common divisor. So this will be non-zero if at least one of them is non-zero. So this is new. So
geçen haftalarda da öyle. Oğlum gelmiyordu iki haftadır derslere. Göreceğiz şimdi.
Okay. So we take an n by n matrix. So for example, we have seen this. So this is a review of last week's lecture. For one, so k and rho of A, so this is the maximum integer k, r.
such a dual and R by R minor with non-zero determinant, non-zero R by R minor. And we have delta k of A is non-zero, and also delta k of A divides delta k plus one of A for one k rho of A minus one.
Remember, when we put our matrix into its Schmidt normal form on the diagonal, we will have, so this on the main diagonal, you can also find them through these greatest common divisors. Okay, and also when we have a matrix with polynomial entries, the first thing that we did was define an equivalence. An equivalence among matrices with polynomial entries is given by elementary row and column operations. We have three types of elementary operations, either multiplying a row or a column with a non-zero constant. Non-zero constant means a non-zero element from our field. You can interchange two rows or two columns, or you can multiply a row with a polynomial from f(x) and add it to another row, similarly to columns. And two matrices, A and B, we say that they are equivalent to each other. If starting from one of them, you can arrive at the other matrix. So this was another. And we know that if two matrices are equivalent to each other, then this delta case must be the same. So let me also remind that theorem. Let A and B are two matrices from here, Fx n by n. Let me repeat this one more time. These you can generalize to non-square matrices also. Then if A is equivalent to B, applying either elementary row operations or elementary column operations. If this is the case, we have so these row A's should be the same. So let's call this number as R, and moreover, delta k of A is equal to delta k of B for k between 1 and R. So, okay, this is done. And so let me also remind you what we mean by Schmidt normal form of such a matrix. So again, so let us take a matrix A in here, F X n by n. And let's
say that this is with R is equal to rho of A, and so we will have a diagonal matrix like this. D, so you will have we have D1 here and then 0 0 D2 0
olmadı, beğenmedim. Şöyle yapayım. Daha güzel yazacağım şimdi.
0 anılasına kağıdını okuyorum sanki. 0
tamam. Çok gerçekçi oldu.
0 bunu da yapamamış. 0 DR buradan biraz puan vereyim. 0 ondan sonra resti 0 pardon, kağıdına geçtim. 0 tamam. Okay.
Tamam. So here, so this is the Smith normal form of your matrix. Remember, in our last example, we have seen two different ways of arriving the Smith normal form. You can either starting from A, apply elementary row and column operations. You can put your matrix into this form, which I will do another example today. Or you may look at k by k minors and then take their greatest common divisors. Tamam. So these are polynomials from fx d1 up to dr. So this is the largest minor, which is non-zero in fx. So these are polynomials fx are monic. So our monic polynomials, and then dk divides dk plus 1 for k between 1 and r minus 1, and moreover this d is equal to P times A times Q. Tamam. You can either evet. So starting from a matrix with polynomial entries. You may apply elementary row and column. What is the idea? You need to put the lowest degree terms. So you will start thinking about all the matrices. Remember the proof. Think about all the matrices which are equivalent to A. There is an entry with the lowest degree polynomial. Put it here. And then get rid of zeros here. Tamam, hatırladınız mı? So if you do it that way, then you will get P as a product of elementary row matrices, Q elementary column matrices. Or you may consider one row to minors, which are just the entries of your matrix. Look at the greatest common divisor, and then look at delta 2, which is the greatest common divisor of two row minors, 2 by 2 minors. So here, P is a product. This is a product of
elementary rolling disease and also remember an elementary row matrix means starting from the identity matrix you apply a single elementary row operation and Q is a product of elementary column matrices. Tamam. The matrix D is said to be, so D is the Smith normal form of A. Tamam. So the matrix D is said to be in Smith normal form. Actually, this type of matrices are used for in algebra to characterize the module structure over principal ideal domains. Or for example, if you have a linear transformation between vector spaces to understand kernel and image, so you take a matrix and put it in, because if it is in this form, it is easier to understand. But later we will take a matrix with scalar entries and consider xi minus a, just the matrix. We will call that matrix as the characteristic matrix of A. It will be a matrix with polynomial entries. Huh? So we are going to use this again. So this is the Smith normal form. You start with your matrix and then. Okay. Now let us see another example. Tamam. So we have already seen one example, a 3x3 matrix where we have seen delta 1, delta 2 and delta 3. And then we find the Smith normal form. Tamam. Hatırladın mı? Yes. Söyle.
Normal sayılardan yani polinomlardan değil de evet. Yıldır elemanların oluşan matrislerde D şey oluyordu ya, D inverse A, B oluyordu ya.
Evet.
Ama burada D şey ring olduğu için inverse diye bir şey yok.
Güzel.
Ondan şey P ve Q şeylerimiz var. Matris, polinom matrislerimiz var. Peki bu yani P ve Q matrislerinin yine o A, 4, A, P gibi bir benzerliği falan olacak
mı? Şimdi onu skader matrislere geçince bir daha sor. Ona da yapacağım. Tamam mı? Onunla ilişki kuracağım. Okay. Tamam. Now an example again. And then throughout the example I will remind you what we mean by... Sen geçen dersi okudun değil mi? Ha? Senin için tekrar yapıyorum. İş nasıl geçti? Girdin mi sen DIF'e? Belki senin DIF sınavın nasıl geçti? Boş kağıt vermişsin. Kağıt boş. Evet. Okay, example. So let me... In this example, I will try to give you an algorithm to find P and Q. Huh? These matrices. Okay, so I will take a small matrix, a 2x2 matrix A. So it is like this. 1 plus x squared, x, then another x, and then 1 plus x. So in this method, I will give, when we arrive at the end, on one hand, we will have this Q, and on one hand, we will have this matrix P. Okay,
So we will somehow, in some sense, form this augmented matrix. It will be like this. 1, 0, so this is a 2 by 2 matrix, 0, 1. On this side, we will work on rows. And then I will write our matrix here. 1 plus x squared, x, x, 1 plus x, and then 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. So this will show the work on rows. And this part work on columns. Work on columns. Ben de diyorum Osman Furkan'a matematikte mantık var. Mahdi yendi diye sevinecek şimdi. İşte hocanın bu tarafı güzel. Good. Evet. Okay. Now let me look at the notes. So here I will take the first row. I will take the okay. So let me denote it like this. Nasıl yapayım? Şöyle. Let us multiply the second row with x plus r2 and then plus r1. Tamam. I will multiply the second row with minus x and add this to the first row. Okay. So the second row will stay here 0, 1. And then I will multiply. So here 0 minus x. Tamam. Now, this is the row operation. This is the corresponding elementary row matrix. Tamam. And then if you do this, so no change in the second row, x, 1 plus x, multiply 1, then minus x, minus x squared, minus x squared. We didn't do any column operation, 1, 0, 0, 1. And then, let me do a column operation now. Aslında burası için bunu yaptım. You are right. Lan şey YouTube çıktı ya. One. Tamam. One. Now let me see. Okay, this is what I did. X squared times as I told you before. This is not the only way, so you may try other ways, but I will do a column and then a row operation. So there is no row operation here. So one minus x zero. 1, and then you are going to multiply the first row with x squared and add it to the second column. So first row will stay 1x, 0, and 1x plus x cubed. Now here 1, 0, x squared, 1. And then and then okay, now I am going to multiply the first row with negative x and then add it to the second row. Tamam.
And then I will get rid of this x. Okay, so this is a row operation. I will multiply the first row. So first row will stay 1 minus x. I'm going to multiply this with minus x. So minus x and then 1 plus x squared here. Now we put our matrix into it is Smith normal form 1, 0, 0, 1 plus x plus x cubed. And then 1 x squared 0, 1. Okay, this matrix is the matrix P. This is D and this is Q. Done. Okay, and so when you put it in this form, we call the diagonal entries as ne diye tanımlamıştık? Invariant factors for our matrix. And onlar nasıldı? F diye mi gösterdim? F diye mi gösterdim? D, D, D. Okay. D1 is equal to 1. And so these are our invariant factors for our matrix A. And D2 is 1 plus x squared. Also, if you go through this greatest common divisor of 2 by k minors, actually FD1, this D1 is nothing but delta 1 of A. And then D2 is delta 2 of A over delta 1 of A. Also we have seen this. Evet, tamam mı? Tamam mıyız? Evet. Smith normal form. This is new for us. And so you may convince yourselves that as we did for matrices in first term, so you can, so let me write it like this. Every matrix, and then I will make one more summary. Every matrix A in Fx n by n is equivalent to precisely one matrix in Smith normal form. Okay, so actually when we say Smith normal form, let me write this immediately. So we will have a D1 here, a D2 here, and then dr here, and then okay, so you will have zeros elsewhere, okay, so in this setup D1 divides D2, this divides this dr, this is r is equal to rho of A, and delta k of A is equal to d1 d2 k. So for example, after you know this, d1 is equal to delta 1 of A,
D2 is equal to delta 2 of A over delta 1 of A. And then eventually dr is delta r of a over delta r minus 1 of a. Tamam. Bunu da yaptım.
Oh, şunu söyleyecektim. Tamam, oradan sonra da oraya geçeceğim. Good. Bunlar bunlardı. Okay.
Hocam, bu üçgen işaretini
delta
karakteristik polinomial olarak da kullanıyorduk ya.
Evet, kullanacağım onu da. Ya, bu kitap böyle gösteriyor.
Aynı şeyi mi farklı bulmak
lazım? Şimdi söyleyeceğim. Şimdi aslında o bir tane matrisin determinantına karşılık geliyor. Değil mi? X, I, eksi A'nın determinantına karşılık geliyor. Birazdan şöyle yapacağım. A diye bir tane matrisi alacağım. F, N, by N diyeceğim. Ondan sonra X, I, eksi A polinomunun X, I, eksi A matrisine bakacağım. Onun determinantı işte buradaki onlardan birine karşılık gelecek. Onun için bu delta'yı kullanıyor kitap. Birazdan niye kullandığını söyleyeceğim. Başka kitaplarda başka şey yapıyor. Bizim kitaptaki mantık. Söyleyeceğim. Orada. Evet. Şimdi, okay. One more example about elementary divisors. And then we are done with this business. Example. Okay. Now here is our matrix. X minus 2, 0, 0, 0. 1, X minus 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, X, 1, minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1, x minus 2. Actually this is xi minus a of a matrix with scalar entries. So now, so. Okay, now I am not going to apply this elementary row operations. But if you apply elementary row and column operations, so let me put three dots here. These are exercises for you. So what you will get at the end is should be like this: one, one, x minus one, and then so two, three, four, one. 3, 4, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, x minus 1 squared, x minus 2. Okay, this is what you should get. Now, invariant factors. Invariant factors. So for invariant factors, we will take the non-trivial entries. By non-trivial, I mean not equal to one. So these are x minus one and x minus one squared, x minus two. Tamam. And you should always check your answer. This should divide the rest. This should divide the rest. This should divide this one. Tamam. So if you look at your notes in invariant, hadi ya öyle mi tanımladım?
Nasıl tanımlamıştım? Ha. Öyle mi dedim? Olmasını. Ne dediğimi ben de çok hatırlamıyorum. Ha bir dakika, benim notlarım var. Bir dakika, notasyonu bir oturtayım. Allah. Tamam, tamam, tamam diyeceğim. Tamam, özür. Özür. Allah'ım, ha. Tamam. Ha evet. Öyle demiş.
Ne diyorsan o.
D1 is 1. D2 is 1. D3 is x minus 1. D4 is x minus 1 squared. X minus 2. Good. Very good. Elementary divisors. Tamam. D1 should divide D2, D2 should divide D3, D3 should divide D4. Elementary divisors. Now you should look at primary, prime polynomials, prime factors. So element with powers. Elementary divisors. So now elementary divisors will be just a list. So you have x minus 1 here. You have x minus 1 and then x minus 1 squared and then x minus 2. These are the elementary divisors. Prime factors with powers. Tamam mıyız? Anlaştık mı? This is this, that is that. Doluk. Doluk, any questions? No hocam. Good. Tamam. Okay. Next. Let me write also this one. İnşallah bir şey unutmadım. Elementary divisors. I will tell you the reason behind this notation.
Yani
hocam dedi ben. Evet, evet. Ya şimdi şu sebeple gakkuk ediyorum. Çünkü şu sebeple gakkuk ediyorum. Her kitapta böyle kullanılmıyor. Hani ben sanki bir mantık var. Burada diğer kitaplarda yok gibi olmasın diye. Tamam mı? Yani bizimkinin mantığını söyleyeceğim şimdi birazdan. Geleceğim.
Cemal amca bir şey düşünmüşler.
He?
Cemal amca bir şey düşünmüşler.
Vallahi Cemal Hoca senin böyle bir şeyler dediğini duysaydı burada seni yerin dibine sokar sokar çıkartırdı. Evet. Koralları. Ben 367 almıştım. Biliyor musunuz 367 diye bir ders var. Cemal Hoca derse geliyor öyle. Başlıyor. Ders bitiyor çıkıyor. Öbür ders geliyor. Aynı kaldığı yerden tak tak tak tak. Nasıl bir şeyse ne? Hem kaldığı yeri hatırlıyor hem de söyleyeceklerini, example'lar falan filan hep aklımda. Kitabı yok. Ama 200, yani lineerler, yani yazılan bir kitap varsa yoktu. Ben aldım. Abstract Algebra.
Biraz bayağı bir şey oluyor.
Evet, çok meşhur. Korolları. Tamam, so again, one more summary. A. And n by n matrix, remember, are elementary matrices. The matrices that we get after a single elementary row or elementary column operation applied to the identity matrix. What we get?
is an elementary matrix. It is invertible because those operations are invertible. So an n by n matrix.
Şeye bakacağım ondan sonra. Okay.
An n by n matrix. Over fx is invertible okay actually here invertible or unit because elementary matrices are invertible or these are unit here means there is a matrix when you multiply with that one you arrive at the identity matrix. Tamam. In that sense, elementary matrices are invertible. So an n by n matrix over fx is invertible if and only if it is a product of elementary matrices. It is a product of elementary matrices and part B two n by n matrices A and B over fx are equivalent. So this is more or less the definition, are equivalent if and only if B is equal to P A Q and P for row operations, Q for column operations, for some invertible matrices, for some invertible matrices P and Q, and part C, equivalent matrices. Equivalent matrices have the same Smith model form.
Tamam.
Hocam burada şey, Q'nun tersi değildi ama şeyden farklı olarak. Formada ekonomi değişimi yaparken ben farklı.
Hayır. Because the, so a matrix over fx is invertible. For example, take an elementary matrix. So you start from the identity matrix. Interchange two rows, you will get an elementary matrix. If you interchange, yeah, so a matrix is invertible if there is another matrix. The reason is we don't have inverses for polynomials. So this is how we are going to define invertibility. A in fx n by n is invertible if there is a b in fx n by n, such that a times b is equal to identity. Tamam ama. Şimdi orada polinom, evet. Şimdi bir yazayım, dur şimdi. Şimdi bununla bunu çarptığımda identity olacak mı diye sordu. Yok. Yani bir tane örnek yaptım zaten. Bunları çarparsan.
Normalde identity yaparken identity diyor ama ne oldu?
Yani hayır, hayır. Evet, aynı matris kullanıyor. Evet.
O da tek matris.
Tamam. Yani burada şuna dikkat etmek gerekiyor. Bir ringin unit'i bu. Ringde bir unit. Yani ringde her şeyin de inverse'i yok. Yani ringde unit olma var. Tamam, neyse şimdi ispatta biraz daha açıklamaya çalışayım. Proof, I will just say a few words about part A. Proof. Part A. Okay. Now let us, so this is an if and only if statement. Let us do it this way. Assume that A is invertible. Assume A is invertible. Assume A is invertible. Okay, now, so first of all we have, so since we start with a matrix A, which is an element of Fx and by n. So long to proof, I will say a few words. Fx and by n. So any matrix here can be put into its Smith normal form. Is this by applying elementary, by applying elementary row and column operations, column operations we may put A into. So when I say normal form, I will mean Smith normal form. Into it is normal form. Okay. So let's say we apply some elementary row operations A, and then some elementary column operations. And then the result is this one. D1, D2, DR, and then 0. Okay. So. Now, so the, here is the idea. So A is invertible, is an invertible matrix. So these are also invertible matrices. So the left hand side is an invertible matrix. Yeah? So it is non-zero determinant. So when you look at the right hand side, the right hand side, you should, so first of all, your first observation should be, if A is an invertible matrix, if A is an invertible matrix, you shouldn't see any zeros here. Huh? And the second one is, so let me write this. After 10 minutes. Tamam. So the idea of Osman Furkan. So also our conclusion will be, there will be no zeros. And then this should be constant matrix. It should be the identity matrix. Huh? So that will be the conclusion after 10 minutes.